Hey guys, V is back with another video review. If you're listening to the soundtrack and you grew up in the 80s, you probably know what this figure is all about. The figure we're reviewing today is a highly anticipated release from the Japanese company HL Pro. So let's start by looking at the box. The box is unfortunately where my disappointment with this figure began. As this figure was put up for pre-order, it was advertised as to coming in a gift box. Unfortunately, what we get with the final product is a very flimsy box that honestly should not be associated with a $200 figure. I mean, I've seen better boxes from figures that were costing half this price. And in today's world, with companies like Sideshow Collectibles and Hot Toys, 3A, Real Action Heroes from Medicom putting out 6-scale figures, honestly HL Pro had no business releasing a box like this. So once you get the figure out of the box, what you're greeted with is a pretty standard affair clamshell, where you can see the figure on the top, and at the back you can see all the accessories that come with the figure. In terms of assembly, the figure pretty much comes assembled right out of the box. The only thing you need to do is insert batteries. Again, HL disappointed by not including batteries, but they did insert a pamphlet telling you the type of battery you need. Inserting the battery is pretty straightforward. You pull out the back of the head and insert the battery. In terms of accessories, unfortunately, you don't get much. But I guess that's what the character's arsenal is. You get, in addition to the hands on him, you get two extra pairs of hands, a buzzsaw hand, an extra gauntlet, and a spear, in addition to a long sword and a short sword. So on with the review. The figure is a 12-inch action articulated figure. Based on the popular show, at least in the Middle East, back in the 80s and early 90s, that was called in Arabic Ar-Rajul Hadidi. The figure has two versions. The one in this review is the regular version. They also have an exclusive version, which is basically the clone of Eisenberg, based on the episode number 31, wherein Eisenberg fought a clone that was sent by the dinosaur army. As far as I know, this happens to be the first 12-inch figure that is released by HL Pro that's articulated. They're mainly known for their 7-inch, 8-inch die-cast figures. And they really went mainstream with their figures that were based on the popular Grandizer series. The regular version retails for about $210, shipping included, to anywhere in the world. And the exclusive retails for about $250, again, shipping included. The figure is based on a body type that I think is proprietary to HL Pro. Unfortunately, it's not a good type, and I'll cover that in a bit more detail at the issues section of this review. The costume is a polyester type fabric. The hands, boots, feet, and head are all plastic. There's no metal or die-cast on this figure. The gauntlets sides are a more pliable plastic, and not the hard type. So are the backs of his boots. So it's pliable again, which is a bit of a disappointment. I would have preferred it to be of a harder plastic type. So let's go over the articulation. The head is on a ball joint, so it can swivel side to side, look down a bit and look up. The shoulder is a regular ball joint, so it can go front, back, and to the side. He has a bicep swivel, an elbow joint that's pretty good in terms of movement. And finally, there's a wrist articulation. His midsection has a joint where you can flex the torso to the front. Moving on to the hips, the leg joint can move in up to a good degree to the front and back. So if you're looking to pose him, it'll be pretty easy, and you could get him into some nice poses. The knee is a double joint, and finally with the foot, you can see that it has articulation again. I think what HL Pro was going for was a high degree of posability, and in that aspect I think the figure succeeds. So what are the issues with the figure? To start with, unfortunately, the figure isn't actually accurate. I had to confirm this by taking a screen grab from the original series, and as you can see, the chest emblem is higher than it should be. The color on the collar piece is off. Similarly, the color on the belt and the gauntlets. The second issue I have is the pliable plastic that they've used on the gauntlet. Unfortunately, as you can see, they're not straight, and while I know that you could use a hair dryer to correct them out, I shouldn't have to with a $200 figure. Next up, and this is where the figure really loses major points with me, is unfortunately the quality control. The neck piece and the shoulder pads are unfortunately glued on with a very flimsy piece of tape. Guys, this is a $210 figure. I understand the shipping's included, and at best maybe that's like $40. This still makes this figure at $160. This is simply inexcusable. With competitors like Hot Toys, Sideshow Collectibles, Medicom, and even the new entries into the market, if you want to succeed and you continue to release figures like this, then honestly you're headed down a wrong path. You have some good licenses that have a large nostalgic following, so if you produce a quality product, people will buy it. But if you continue to release products like this, which are subpar, there's only so far where the nostalgic value can take you, and then people will notice and just move elsewhere. So take notice, and hopefully this will be corrected in their upcoming releases. The last issue I want to cover is basically because of the body type that HL Pro chose for this figure. The fabric tends to bunch up along the loose joints, especially around the pelvic area, and it creates an unsightly view if you tend to move the figure around or articulate it. I think with a more buff figure or a better type, this problem should go away. So what's the final verdict? Unfortunately, if you're an Iserberg fan, this is the only example that's available in terms of 12-inch figures. But sadly, HL Pro, I'd have to rate this pretty low. I'd give this a 50. So if you're a fan of the character, yeah, go ahead and buy it. But if you're not, I would suggest you wait till a better example is released. To wrap up, thank you for watching. If you've enjoyed this video, I would really appreciate if you'd like, share, comment, and subscribe. I really welcome feedback, and I'm always looking for ways to improve my videos. Until I see you next time, this is VA tuning out.